Hello and welcome, my friend. Next, I am planning to show you that how to use this metal saw and this metal saw with this specific blade what cuts steel. And normally when we have that kind of blade, this is made for only for cut steel parts like this small screw. And next, quite soon I am planning to show you that how to cut that screw. But before of that, I like to show also you that when we have this metal saw frame, we need to install in some day or in some times this new blade. And we can purchase these blades in any those hardware stores like maybe in Target, and then this Home Depot is excellent place to get these parts. And then when you purchase these blades, there is really that quality matters. I have in here this blade. This is safety blade, and this is made even in Germany, and German they do quite good quality, and I can recommend that if you have high quality countries like of course USA, England, Japan, or then some other countries, they are good. And also this Germany is this fine brand, and please check always that you have this high quality blade what is this made in country. I always purchase high quality blades. No ever blades where it's like made in some Asian country. This symbol. Only countries in Asia what are high quality, they are Japan and of course this South Korean. They do quite fine quality. Okay, and then we need to purchase this blade like Home Depot, and this blade cost about $2 to $5. And then this installation is interesting because when we have this old blade, we need to normally replace this blade when this blade went cut, or then this blades, this cutting area, what is that area? There are those small shark teeth what I am now touching. When this area becomes dull and it is not anymore sharp, then we need to replace that. And this replace happens so that there is this adjusting bolt in that area, and first I need to rotate that open that this part start to move. And first I insert that my blade in this way. Look, these small feet are in down, not in that way. If we install that in this way, then this is already dull. And that way, and then when I install in here, look, first this area, and then when I am starting to adjust that area, note, the idea is that I need to move that bolt in that way. And then when it's fine, in that, this small hole in here, what is in here, it goes in that area, and then we check that this area, this point, and this spike is in this hole, and also in here, this point, look in that way, and then teeth is in that position, and then we take our fingers in here, and then I start to fasten and rotate that adjusting bolt in that way, that I rotate that in this way, and then this part start to move in here, and this blade becomes tighter, more tight, and then when we adjust that, idea is then to check that is this part enough tight. And there is good thing that when we insert that our blade in here, and then we press something like two fingers or one hand, and it takes a little bit like half not half inch, only like 0.1 or 2 inches down, then this is fine, and I can also rotate, and it is actually better what a tighter it is, but always a little bit flexibility is good, look, in that way. Okay, now this my blade is ready for cutting, and there is this my target, and then I need, of course, I need my workbench, and my workbench, it is in here, and let's look my workbench, it is there. And then we look that little bit closer. There is my workbench. And then I insert this my small screw in between these two teeth. And the idea is that when I rotate that part in here, in that way, then this part moves and it tightens. This is actually really big force when I rotate that in this way, and this is high quality workbench. This cost about $100 or maybe even in 200, and then I insert carefully that my screw in here in that way, and now I think that this is not good idea, I need to rotate that in another way, then it takes better contact in that way. And then idea is that I fasten this my bench so much that this is tight, and now this screw is in there, and we can even look that little bit closer what it looks like. It looks like that. Good. And then I can start to use this my metal saw blade. And I am planning to cut this head part away. And I insert my this blade in here. And then when I start to cut that my bolt, there is idea that I don't press that my saw very much down, only in that kind of movement, and then when it takes in here small contact, because this is, I can start to press that my blade down, because there is thing that now if I press that down totally, this metal blade, it normally cuts in here, and it is bad. And that way, and another hand in here, and then only couple of 20 to 40 cuttings, and this is cut, and this 40 movement like that way. 1, 2, 1, and then if this blade moves too much, I can adjust that more tight. And if you have weak fingers, you can use also tongs. Like in here, tongs, and then do a little bit more, but remember that if we fasten that too much, this blade can go cut in here, but now it's really well, okay, and I estimate that 20 to 40 that kind of movement, and then this is cut, okay, now I calculate, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, very well. And now, this my bolt, it is cut, there is this head area in here, and in that area, when we look in here, I take that my cut end part also away. Now they are in there, and we can look those small parts in there. They are in here. And we can actually go to look those even closer, because they are really interesting. What they look like. There are those parts. Excellent. And then, can I use this my metal blade for some other materials cutting? Like wood or plastic? There is wooden pencil, and answer is of course. And let's look how it happens. There is my workbench, and then I insert this my pencil in here, and I like to cut a little bit that part. And this is very excellent, this cut tool, and I think that 10 movement and this is nicely cut. And this blade makes very nice cutting this shape and blade. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it was 5. Okay, and then let's go to look that result, and result cutting is really excellent. And let's go to look closer. Look. There's really nice this, and there is this area too, and this cutting is very nice. And then what else I can very easily cut with this my cutting tool? There is of course all materials what we can test. And next I have in here this interesting cutting. That I have this cell phones, this electric loading device, and then I think that can I cut this in here? This is like plastic. And answer is that of course. And then I insert that my spare part in here, in that way, and then I believe that something, and now I am, this is like extra old part, I don't need that anymore, but I think that maybe I like to cut that kind of device, and this is like 20 to 40 movement, and it is cut. Let's look what happens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Nice. And look that result. It is excellent. And then I take this part away. And there is this device. And let's go to look this cutting area. Because it looks really interesting. And it looks like that. Very well. Look at how nice this cutting is. Okay. And that kind of information. That how to use this metal saw. And I am really brand and a fan of this metal blade. Because I start to use this metal blade when I was 6 years old. 6 years, I was small kid. And I remember even today that how to nice this metal saw is to use. And then of course I like to show that how to replace this metal blade. If this is like dull. Because it is also interesting again. And now when I like to replace this blade, I need to first only rotate, if this is like dull. I rotate that part in here, and then there is this old part, and when I install that new part in here, in same idea, and then when it is in back in here, this is the key point, start to rotate that in that were enough tight, and now my blade is ready for use. Okay, thank you for watching that my video, and have a nice day to you, and see you in next movie.